It's time for TV's all-time favorites on Family Feud. 5 days of feuds among the original cast of Leave It to Beaver, the Leave It to Beaver family. Jerry Mather, Barbara Billingsley, Frank Banks, Richard Deacon, Ken Osmond, reunited again, ready for action.
Thank you. Let's leave it to Beaver. Thank you, Richard. How are you doing?
Real good.
Good to see you.
Nice to be here.
I gotta say it. Hi, Bea.
Hi, Richard. Wanna go play ball?
Sure. Love to do it.
Everyone's All-American mother, Barbara Billingsley. June Cleaver.
She always does.
She does indeed.
And next to her, we have Frank Bank, and he's Lumpy Rutherford. He's also a securities dealer.
How are you? Welcome. Yes, we are welcome.
And then Mr. Rutherford, Richard Deacon, but Richard is actually an author. He writes cookbooks.
I know he does.
And how to cook with a microwave.
Well, you sent me the very first edition you ever did.
You didn't send it back.
Works like a charm. I use it. I love it, Richard. Smart. And
next to him, the infamous Eddie Haskell, who is actually Ken Osmond, Officer Osmond of the Los Angeles Police Department.
Hey, welcome. Good to have you here. My, you certainly look nice today, Mr. Dawson.
Tell Easton, you better watch yourself now.
Not at all.
Okay. It's kind of neat that you've all gone straight here. I'm very proud of you. Look at this.
Thank you very much.
I wish it to match your beauty.
Thank you.
You're gorgeous.
Thank you.
For being here. Securities?
Yeah, municipal bonds,
right.
And we build cities and sewers. We put your money in a sewer.
I live in one of those, but I won't tell you which one. Thanks for being here.
My pleasure.
First show I ever did, network show in the United States. This man helped me through it.
And you gave me that.
I did a film called The Devil's Brigade, because she collects hats. He's my old buddy.
It's not in the Salvation Army. Thank you.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Long time, huh?
All right.
Yeah. That's the hat that we wore in the Devil's Brigade that we do with Bill Holden, and he loves hats. I'll try and find you another hat.
Thank you, I'd appreciate it.
Richard. Good to have you here.
Yes, it's a ball to be here.
How long have you been in the police force?
13 years now.
Get out of here. Right, Steve, we can get $100 for you. Start with the footlighters. No?
I'm sorry, Gary.
Don't worry about it. They're both lucky. We're going to play the feud. Let's go!100 people surveyed, top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something a man gives to his wife less and less frequently as their marriage grows older. Babe.
Flowers.
Flowers. No hesitation. They're going to play, my love. That's the way to do it. Braid 43. The Beaver? Nothing yet. Come on, sweet mama. Come on. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an animal that might chase a man.
A dog.
A dog. By Henry Gibson.
Number one.
They
want to
play
with you. Little bird. Deja vu. That's how we started the last one. Biggie there. 131. It rained. Nothing yet. Believe it. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an actor who played a hoodlum in movies.
Jimmy Cagney.
Jimmy Cagney. Great. Great.
Okay. Yeah, we're going to play.
All righty. Seems I knew he'd like that. Come on now. Actor who played a hoodlum in the movie.
Betty Davis.
Betty's there, okay. First strike.
In a Disney.
100 people surveyed, top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something a woman tries to guess about a man before a blind date.
His age.
His age.
For the player call.
You want to play?
Yeah!
He's going to play.
He's going to play?
I can tell that. He's gone. Are you rushing off to the victory celebration? You're
well, that's one out of 20.
Yeah,
why not?
That's what I'm saying. People survey, top four answers on the board. This will decide it. Name something a guest might take home as a memento of a wedding.
Ken. The bouquet.
Bouquet? Three answers a minute, Russell. Give me an answer.
The bride.
The bride. We'll go back and explain your answer to you after you're in play. Name something. I knew we'd all meet again here. $1 again or tripled. 100 people surveyed, top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a kind of pill some people take every day.
Vitamin
pill. Name something people carry with them to work every day.
A lunch pail.
How few hours of sleep you can get by on.
Five.
Something with raisins in it.
Cookies.
A tool everyone uses.
Silverware.
A color of toothpaste.
White.
Turn around. I only wish Rod Serling were still around.
So do I.
Something people carry with them to work every day, lunch pail. There is it. A few hours you think you get by on. 5 hours. There is it. Something with raisins in it. Cookies. We love cookies. Survey. Great thing, of course, that Trini Lopez, a big hit song, a tool that everyone uses. If I had a silverware. Survey! Don't look at me and gloat. You know it was terrible. Tell her a toothpaste. She said white. Survey said.
Hey, we got Spike right here.
Did not say Betty Davis. Right here. 47 points, you got the money. Please remind everyone, the great answers, with one exception that Richard gave us, and give us 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name something people carry with them to work every day.
A briefcase.
How few hours of sleep you can get by on.
Five.
Try again.
Four.
Something with raisins in it.
Grape nuts. Cereal.
A tool everyone uses.
Hammer.
A color of toothpaste.
White.
Try again.
Blue.
Turn around. Something people carry with them work every day. Lunch is number one. You said briefcase. Survey said.
20.
How few hours of sleep you can get by on? 6 hours was the number one answer. You said 4 hours. You need 26 points. For $5,000. Survey said. 24. Something with raisins in it. Richard gave me the number one answer, cookies. You said cereal. 2 points and the footlighters have $5,000. Survey.
Thank you.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. A Mark Simpson television production.
Tonight, the Fonz crashes high society on Happy Days.
It's time for TV's all-time favorites on Family Feud. 5 days of feud among the original cast of Leave It to Beaver. Today's feud, the Leave It to Beaver family. Jerry Mathers, Barbara Billingsley, Frank Bank, Richard Deacon, and Ken Osmond, reunited again, ready for action, competing against
the Beaver, right here. Hi, Bean.
How you doing, Richard?
I love that. I've always wanted to talk to him. I told him when he first came on. I do watch your show even now because it's like Hogan's. It's floating through the air.
All over.
And if I ever hear your voice, I go...
Hi, Bean.
Well, thank you, Richard.
Usually they take me away, of course. Let's meet everybody, please.
Everybody's All-American Mom, Barbara Billingsley.
Hello, Richard.
Where's Barbara? Lumpy Rutherford, right bank, who's now a securities dealer.
Sure is, and a dynamite player.
Mr. Micro Magic. He is now doing cookbooks for microwaves. He sold, what, 1.5 million copies so far, Richard? Richard Deacon.
Richard.
And then my nemesis over there, Eddie Haskell. Mm-hmm. Ken Osmond, who's actually Officer Osmond of the LAPD.
13 years of post. You know, I'm delighted you came here. You made a dream come true. I swear, in the front row, I've got four friends here. The Abadesses, who've come all the way in. Well, I think Laverne. Which is further from here, Laverne or Shirley? No, like, he came in to see the show, he loves the show.
Well, thank you.
Of course, he also thought that Epton was going to win in Chicago. Truly, Footlighters, a marvelous charity. What, you raise over $1 million or
so? Over $1 million in the last few years.
You're special.
Thank you.
How are you? Great player, but doing very well. His insecurities. Give me some advice a little later. Very first television show, network show I did, Dick Van Dyke show. This man was my guardian angel on it. You're a nice man.
You certainly look nice today, Mr.
Well,
Dawson.
Thank you, officer. But you, I can't. I just see him in that show and I hear that voice. Would you take a lucky lollipop? I see if we can get it.
Listen, Jerry picked out the one earlier, pointed to one and said, that's the one. So.
Which one do you think, Jer? That one, right?
That looks like a good one.
Oh, hey, come on. Hey,
Dave. I can't win them all.
Beav, that was not a good choice.
Well, I'm working on it.
Hey, Meredith, you gotta take a lollipop. I forgot to tell you to take a lollipop. Where did this one come from? Okay, here we go. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. You gotta try and get the most popular answer, and here's the question. Name something that's hard to do without for a whole day. Yeah.
Cigarettes for smokers.
Cigarette?
Come on, babe.
That's happy, Richard.
Well, I know it's tough, babe. That's why Wally didn't show.
Okay, guys. What is it?
Sleep.
I think we're going to have to go with sleep.
Well, of course, you misforce yourself. Get some sleep at night. But sleep is your answer.
That's what I...
Fine. Sleep! Top 7 answers on the board. Here's the question. What's the first song you remember learning how to sing?
Yeah. Pledge of Allegiance. You know, Oh Say Can You See?
Oh Say Can You Pledge?
Rock-a-bye Baby.
Rock-a-bye Baby.
Oh.
What? Laurie. No. Laurie.
Oh, I just had it. Oh.
3 seconds.
London Bridge is falling down.
London Bridge is falling down into Lake Havasu. First song you remember learning how to sing, Frank?
America. In school, they all...
Who teaches them, Ray Charles?
No, the first grade you learned.
America! America! No, the first song you remember learning how to sing, you know.
When I came over from Sweden, I learned God Bless America.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
God Bless America.
So much for my patriotism.
It's amazing I learned God Bless Sweden at the same time. Richard, can you help us here, please?
Happy birthday to me.
To you.
Yeah.
Happy birthday to Richard. All musical question.
Good.
And now we see one of two for Petticoat and the Beaver. Nothing yet. Come on, Frank. Come on. People survey top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something specific that people suck on. Yes.
Milk when they're a baby.
Milk. Sorry, please.
What are you going to say?
A pipe?
Come on.
A cigar?
They're moving at the speed that they're showing the top ten here. I can't believe. What's your answer?
Pipe.
That's right, suck on a pipe. Well, fancy about This day you get the $71, Jerry, and if not, big lead for Frank and the ladies. A pipe? Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something for which Liz Taylor is famous. Yes.
Bazooms.
This is not exactly chopped liver right here. Bazoom! Two salmon kettle. What's the number one answer for most mistakes? This show came second. Carnation was the flower in a gossage. All clothes, excluding barbells, to the gym. White was the number one for socks. And bad weather, such as rain, can ruin a picnic. So now, Petticoat Junction, playing with cerebral palsy, won $10,800. Music the Beaver playing for the Foot Lions and won $5,405. And for the House Ear Foundation, the Brady Bunch tomorrow play Petticoat Junction. They have won $5,788. Tomorrow they play for $10,000. We love you. We'll see you on the street.
This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud. Hey, Mark Goodson, television production.
Tonight, discover Hollywood oddities on Ripley's Believe It or Not.